Hello everyone, welcome to another lecture of the course Digital Signal Processing. In the previous lectures, we have seen how to design various types of filters, that is low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter and the band stop filter. We saw that the typical frequency response for a low pass filter is something like this, that is equal to 1 for the frequency range of minus omega c to omega c, where this omega c is the cutoff frequency. And its time domain equivalent is given as HLP of n is equal to sine of omega c n upon pi n, where this n is not equal to 0. And it is equal to omega c by pi for n equal to 0. The high pass filter is given as something like this. So we can see that it passes the frequencies that are greater than this cutoff frequency omega c, and its time domain equivalent can be given as HHP of n is equal to minus sine omega c n upon pi n for n not equal to 0, and it is equal to 1 minus omega c by pi for n equal to 0. The bandpass filter passes only a particular band of frequencies, say from omega c1 to omega c2, and its time domain equivalent was found as HBP of n is equal to sine of omega c2 n minus sine of omega c1 n upon pi n for n not equal to 0, and it is equal to omega c2 minus omega c1 upon pi for n equal to 0. And the bandstop filter rejects the frequency components that are available in the particular band of frequency, that is omega c1 to omega c2, and its time domain equivalent is given as HBS of n is equal to sine of omega c n, sine of omega c1 n minus sine of omega c2 n upon pi n for n not equal to 0, and it is equal to 1 plus omega c1 minus omega c2 upon pi for n equal to 0. And we also saw that these ideal filters can be used for finding an FIR filter or designing an FIR filter by just truncating it with window and introducing a delay of m by 2, where this m is the order of the filter. So, in this lecture, we are going to observe the pole zero plots for the FIR causal filters for low pass, high pass, band pass, as well as the band stop filter. So, let's start. So, if we observe this, this is a typical low pass filter, and if we see its length, so this is a low pass filter. Of length equal to 11, and therefore its order, that is m, will be equal to 10. So if we observe the time domain equivalent, we can see that it is valid or it exists from n equal to 0 to n equal to 10. And this is the frequency domain representation. We can see that it passes the frequencies only till a particular cutoff frequency, whereas it attenuates the other frequencies. And the cutoff frequency for this filter was omega c equal to pi by 2. Now if we observe the pole zero plot of this filter, we can see that all the zeros are concentrated near omega equal to pi or near z equal to minus 1. So what we observe is the zeros are close to z equal to minus 1 point, or are concentrated near the frequency of plus minus pi. Now we know that we need to attenuate this frequency. This plus minus pi frequency is to be attenuated in this high pass, in this low pass filter, and hence these zeros bring down the amplitude of the frequency response at these frequency components. And hence for a low pass filter, we have the zeros concentrated mostly towards omega equal to plus minus pi, whereas we need to pass the frequencies near omega equal to 0, that is z equal to 1, that is we need to pass the frequencies at omega equal to 0, and hence no zeros should be present at z equal to 1, that is at omega equal to 0. So same thing can be observed here. No zero is available at omega equal to 0 or z equal to 1. One more thing that we can observe here is, if we see this, see these zeros, we can see that this zero that is located here and this zero located here are exactly the reciprocals of each other. For example, if this is z naught, then this zero is 1 upon z naught, and similarly, if this zero is z1, then this zero is 1 by z1. So what we say is, if z0 is the zero of this filter, then 1 upon z0 is also the zero of a filter. One more thing that we can observe from the time domain representation is, this time domain representation is symmetric, and it is symmetric about m by 2. So this time domain representation is symmetric about m by 2, and we can represent it mathematically as h of n is equal to h of m minus n. So these are some of the interpretations that we can have from the time domain representation as well as the pole zero plots. So let us move ahead for the high pass filter. So this is the high pass filter. So this is its time domain equivalent, and again we can see that it is symmetric about m by 2. So the time domain representation again is symmetric, and again we have the same condition, h of n is equal to h of m minus n. If we observe the frequency domain representation, we can see that these frequency components that are nearer to zero are completely attenuated. So this gives us some intuition that the zeros for this filter should be concentrated more towards z equal to 1, or the frequency or the orientation of omega equal to 1, omega equal to 0, and same can be observed here. We can see that all the zeros, or most of the zeros, are located near z equal to 1 or omega equal to 0. So we can say that for a high pass filter, zeros are located near z equal to 1, plus we can say that no zero is located at z equal to minus 1 or omega equal to plus minus pi, because we need to pass the frequencies at plus minus pi, as this is a high pass filter. A similar observation that we had for the low pass filter can be seen here. That is, suppose this zero is located at z naught, then this zero is basically located at 1 upon z naught. And similarly, if this is at z1, this is at z1 inverse, that is 1 upon z1. So again, for this filter, if z naught is the zero, it implies that 1 upon z naught is also a zero of the filter. So let us move on for the bandpass filter. So this is the time domain representation of the bandpass filter, which is again symmetric. So this is the bandpass filter. About m by 2, and again we have the same condition, that is h of n is equal to h of m minus n, and we can see that it passes the frequency ranges within a particular band, whereas attenuate the frequency ranges that are near zero as well as near the plus minus pi point. So again we have an intuition that we should have the zeros that are located closer towards omega equal to 0 and omega equal to plus minus pi, or in other words, the zeros must be concentrated nearer to plus minus 1. So same thing can be observed here. So the zeros are concentrated near to the point z equal to plus minus 1. Therefore, for a band pass filter, zeros are concentrated near z equal to plus minus pi. And again, the reciprocal observation can be seen from these four points, and we can conclude that if z naught is the zero, it implies that 1 upon z naught is also the zero, for the particular system. Now if we look at the band stop filter, so this is the representation for the band stop filter. And from its frequency domain representation, we can see that the band, that is this particular band, is attenuated, whereas all the other frequencies are passed, and hence it is the band stop filter, and again it is symmetric about m by 2. And hence we have the condition, that is h of n is equal to h of m minus n. And now for this we need to have zeros that are away from z equal to 1 and z equal to minus 1 point. So for a band stop filter, we have zeros quite away from z equal to plus minus 1 point, because we need to pass both the frequencies, that is plus minus pi as well as 0, and that's why we don't need to have a zero that is located close to z equal to plus minus 1. And again we have the same reciprocal representation, that is if z naught is the zero, which implies that 1 upon z naught is also the zero. So in this lecture, what we saw that for low pass filter, the zeros are concentrated more towards z equal to minus 1, that is omega equal to pi, rather omega equal to plus minus pi, and no zeros are located at z equal to 1, as we don't need to attenuate the frequencies or the lower frequencies. The opposite case is observed for the high pass filter, in which the zeros are concentrated more towards z equal to 1, that is omega equal to 0, that is lower frequencies, and no zero is observed at z equal to minus 1, that is omega equal to plus minus pi. For bandpass filter, the zeros are concentrated more towards z equal to plus minus 1, that is omega equal to 0 and omega equal to plus minus pi, because we need to attenuate both the frequencies, that is higher as well as lower frequencies, and rather pass a particular band of frequencies between these two higher and lower frequencies. And for the band stop filter, again we will have the completely opposite thing for as that of band pass filter. So in band stop filter, the zeros are concentrated away from z equal to plus minus 1, that is omega equal to 0 and omega equal to plus minus pi. Another observation that we had was, if z equal to z naught is a zero of the filter, then z equal to 1 upon z naught is also the zero of the filter. And one more thing that we saw, that the expressions for LPF, HPF and BPF, and as well as for the BSF, that is band stop filter, are symmetric in nature, and these are symmetric. So these are symmetric about m by 2, and we have the relation that h of n is equal to h of m minus n. So let's stop here. Thank you.